Hey fam, I want you to like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, youtube.com/RolandSMartin. And don't forget to turn on your notifications.
Well, let's now go to Columbus, Ohio, where community organizer Amber Evans has been missing for nearly a month. Her car was found, but very few details have emerged since then. Evans was an outspoken critic of the Columbus Police Department, and many believe that they're just not trying hard enough to find her. A couple of days ago, I got an email from Amber's mother, Tonya Fischer. We, of course, have been covering this case. I've had numerous people asking me to cover this case. I sent text messages to members of Congress as well, asking them to pay attention about this case as well. And so I'm glad that Tonya sent me that email. Tonya, welcome to Roland Martin Unfiltered.
Hey, good morning.
So first, the last time you talked to and saw your daughter?
The last time I had spoke to my daughter was the Saturday before Monday, and she had spent time that Friday with her siblings at my mother's home, and they had all got together. They had a great time, from what I understand. I was in Cleveland for a little bit that evening on Friday. So then Saturday, I didn't talk to her Friday night, but then Saturday I talked to her in the mid-afternoon, and we had a real good conversation. She seemed to be really good in spirits. I was asking her how the new job was going and everything. She was like, it's work. And then I was like, well, I understand. I said, so what's going on with it? And she was just like, it's just trying to pull things together, you know, because it's a new position. I said, yeah. And then I said, well, you're getting ready to turn, you know, 29 coming up. And I said, so, you know, I always have this running joke with my other kids and with all the kids, really, that, you know, I have 6 kids. So I'm going to graduate 6 times. I'm going to go to college 6 times, all those things. So I said, Amber, I said, what are we going to do in our 30, 40 life, you know? And I said, what would you want to do that would make you really happy? And if you didn't have to think about anything else, what would you do that you could just let go of and just be happy? And she said she would want to go back to Paris, where she spent some time. I think it was like 7.5 months there, altogether 14 months in Paris, teaching English to the kids over there.
So what I'm trying to understand, I've been reading these stories. So she drives her car to a particular area that she liked to often go to, and is it this Scioto River? Did they discover her car door open, or did they discover, was her purse there? Was her belongings there? And from police, they just say she's just gone.
Yeah, so I was the one that discovered her car based off of what her boyfriend Mark told me. And just shocked.
So her and so I understand, her and her boyfriend had an argument?
Well, I don't think it was quite an argument. I just think at this point in time, I think Amber was just kind of tired of, you know, being in this relationship, and was trying to look for a future life, you know, like what it means to be an executive director of a organization that deals mainly with the Black community. And Amber was kind of like the modern day Angela Davis. She had been
right,
like the trips and things, you know, around to North Carolina, to the plantations, to the, you know, cotton fields and things. And so she was just getting more and more in tune with her African-American side.
So did the boyfriend call you? And then did you then say, let me try to go out and find her? And then that's why you discovered the car?
Well, I had received a text. All of us had received a text. Just a 2-word, which is kind of strange because Amber is a writer. So, you know, usually if she's going to write you something, it's going to be a long paragraph, a long page, or a book, just to say whatever she was feeling. So that kind of caught me off guard. And then when I got the text, I just kind of responded back to her, like, what are you talking? Like, you know, what do you mean? And so then, at the same time, my phone rings, and it happened to be Mark, and he was crying and upset, and I got kind of alerted because I had just walked in the door with my other daughter and was preparing her for college, and it just caught me off guard to hear him crying and to receive that text from Amber. So I just kind of got my stuff back going. I was running back to the car. And so at this point, he told me where she was. And so that
And according to the story, she sent a text that said, "I love you and I'm sorry."
Right. Exactly.
So that was that text
on
came
Monday night.
It came in at 8:07 p.m.
Yeah.
And do you believe that the Columbus Police Department is doing all they can? I'm reading one story. They're saying that the conditions of the Skeeto River have been too difficult for them to actually search for her body.
We had ordered for a meeting with them because after, you know, almost going into 3 weeks of just total nightmare, just worry, just crying, just not knowing anything, not hearing anything. I had never talked to the lead detective before, and he didn't interview me or anything. And so at that point, I was just a little bit furious and frustrated.
Mm-hmm.
So I had, that's when I guess everybody had reached out on the behalf of me, you know, hearing my stories, hearing my frustration. And I guess that's when Congresswoman Betty got involved. And at that point, they allowed us to have a meeting with them. And so in this meeting, I brought seven of my top family, you know, members and friends. And we began to question them pretty heavily about things. And it still wasn't making a lot of sense because we've seen numerous times on television, on the news at 11 o'clock, you know, Fox News at 10 o'clock, all these different genres, MSNBC, news channels that, you know, when people are missing of the opposite race, they run in, they're diving in.
Well, look, we've covered those. Look, that's the reality is that when it's white, they're right. And they cover those stories. That was one of the reasons why we wanted to keep this focus as well. You're a former mental health worker. And this is the last question for you. You're adamant that your daughter did not commit suicide.
I'm very adamant of that because it just is not adding up. And for everybody to just, well, not just everybody, but the boyfriend to be so final. And then for him to be executing things with even her landlord, like for him to bail out of the apartment that they're staying in, to run home to his parents, to the things that are set up the way that they are, things just don't make sense. And it's just the truth. It just doesn't add up and make sense. We need some answers to a timeline. And we need those answers now. And I'm the one that's giving the police the avenues of what they need to know as far as, you know, things that I'm finding and discovering. I'm passing that on.
Gotcha.
And now I'm the one that's talking directly to the sergeant of the Columbus Police Department. I'm no longer dealing with the lead detective. So at this point, we just need answers, and they're promising, you know, now we're just now lighting the fire.
Right.
You know, which is sad because it's 5 weeks and we've lost so much ground. So it just seems like we're just now lighting the fire. But to let them know, and for the world to know, that we are not going to stop. This is my job now.
Right.
And I'm not going to stop as a mother. I mean, if you know anything about, you know, the cord that ties a mother to their child, I'm that mother. I don't stop. I won't, you know, quit. It won't. There's nothing that is going to make this any different. So they better get ready because it isn't going to end.
Well, Tonya, we certainly appreciate you reaching out to me, sending me that email. That's why we wanted to have you on. Folks, if you have any information regarding Amber Evans, the Columbus Police Department's Missing Persons Unit is 614-645-4280, 614-645-4280. Tonya, we're going to be hoping for the best. We're going to keep the attention on this story as well, because one of the reasons we created this show is because we understand the mainstream media doesn't cover our stories. And so hopefully somebody who's watching this right now on YouTube or Facebook or Periscope got any information. Hopefully we can have some good news about the whereabouts of your daughter, Amber Evans. We appreciate you joining us.
Yes. Thank you, Roland. Thank you, Jackie.
All right. Tonya Fischer, thanks a bunch, the mother of Amber.
Back to that Roland Martin Unfiltered video in just one moment.
All right, folks, calling all HBCU alumni, students, and leaders. Enter the Ford Motor Company HBCU Mobility Challenge and win $25,000 for your school. Building on their long-term support of HBCUs, Ford is looking to improve mobility in HBCU communities through innovative solutions. The winning program will receive a grant of up to $25,000 to implement the proposal. Now, the deadline to apply is March 31st, 2019. Go to FGB.Life for more information to apply. FGB.Life for more information to apply. And if you're watching, tell your HBCU that if they don't know about this, they need to be doing it. You should be pushing this on social media. Again, folks, 25 grand that could go to one of the HBCU campuses. Ford goes further in our community, and we certainly appreciate them being a partner here on Roland Martin Unfiltered.
Now back to your Roland Martin Unfiltered video.